Today I'm going to show you an awesome effect creating a picture in 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 a picture. Hey guys, welcome to Phlearn. My name's Aaron Nace. You can find me on Twitter at AKNacer. I'm super excited about this tutorial. We're doing something that I've never even done before. We just figured out how to do it, and we're gonna put a picture inside of a picture over and over and over again, and it's gonna be awesome. This is a image from Ima, and this is from Brussels. So Ima, awesome image, and hey, we're gonna give you a Phlearn Pro just because we're working on your image. Let's get into it, and we're gonna start off. We were looking at this image, and Zach had the idea to put her into the projector screen. And I thought that was a really cool idea. But there's one thing we need to do to start off with. We need to get a little bit more real estate in the projector screen, because ideally we would want it to be about the same aspect ratio, about the same size as the actual boundary of the entire image. So how do we do that? Well, that's a good question. What we're gonna do, first of all, I'm gonna hit C for the crop tool. And we're gonna just click the top arrow and just drag that up just a bit. Something like that, just to give us some more room on the top. And I'm gonna hit enter. Okay, so now we've got a little bit more room on the top. What we need to do now is actually extend all this up. Because we have a blank wall in this image, it's pretty easy to do. If you guys are gonna work on something where there's like, you know, a forest in the background or a lot of detail, a city, it's gonna be a little bit harder. So if you do need to extend borders, it's best to do it when you have blank walls. So let's hit Command J on our, there we go. Let's just enter that in. Okay, we're gonna hit Command J on our background, and I'm just gonna drag that all the way up to the top. There we go, right up there. Now our goal is to make it look as though this blends in and it's just one picture. It probably won't be that hard. Let's see. It might be extremely hard. What we're gonna do is use a black layer mask, and I'm just gonna layer mask away the bottom of this image. And the goal here is to get it to just, like, you know, look like it's connecting. All right, so layer masking away the bottom of that image, and, you know, so far looking pretty good, not that hard. And we're just kind of getting to this area where it's just gonna get a little bit funky here, you know, with our projector, because the projector doesn't go that far, but now the paintings are just taller, so not a big deal. So what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna make a new projector, because it's just, you know, flat and it's not really that hard. So we're just gonna make a new projector. So we're gonna make a new layer, and you can use a couple different tools here. Now I'm actually going to be, I want this to be square, a little bit more square. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna use the marquee tool. If you wanted to stick with, you can see it's at a slight angle. You could use the lasso tool here, but it would just be a little bit easier to use the rectangular marquee tool here. So I'm gonna just make a rectangular marquee, and we're just gonna go all the way down to the bottom here. There we go, that looks pretty good. And make that into a selection. Okay, now what we're gonna do is on the inside of this, I'm just gonna grab our brush tool, and we're gonna paint with dark color. I'm gonna hold Alt or Option with my brush tool to grab that color. Okay, so that's the color of our border now. And we can see it looks really good so far. Next thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna go to Select and then down here to Inverse. So now it's gonna paint outside of that selection. And now, again, what we're gonna do is grab our brush tool, okay? And then I'm gonna hold Alt or Option, grab that color from the outside there. And, you know, now I'm just painting the wall from the outside. I'm just painting that color. There we go. I can hit Command H to hide the selection so you can see what we're doing here. Looking pretty neat, right? Okay. Let's go ahead and hit Select and then down to Inverse again. There we go, looking pretty good. So we got a square there. And then you can just right click in here. Make sure you're on a selection tool. Right click and go to Transform Selection, or you just make a new one, but I just kind of felt like transforming this one. There we go, we'll just bring in our edges and hit Enter. And now, because we're inside of the selection, we're just gonna paint with this nice light white color. Very cool. All right, so, you know, making a projector screen. It's not that hard. I mean, it's like, you know, there are harder things to make in life than a projector screen, for instance. If you wanted to make this perfect, you can go down to the very edge. And I mean, you could use like a pen tool and stuff like that. I'm just gonna use a hard edge and just kind of, like, you know, paint that up like that, and then, you know, paint our edge here. You know, this is something that you could spend a bit of time on and make it perfect. And if this was, you know, an image you were going to be posting online, I'd spend a little bit more time than this. But this is a tutorial, so that's pretty good for a tutorial. So what we've got now is a extended image, and we've got a larger projector up there, which is very cool. So now what we're going to do with the projector is we're going to take the whole image and then stick it in the projector. To do that, we're going to make a new layer. So Shift Option Command N is going to make a new layer. Now we're going to hold down Shift Option Command, these three buttons. If you're on a PC, it's going to be Shift Alt and Control, and we're going to hit E, as in ears. Yep, ears. So we're going to hit E, and that's what that's going to do is it's going to make a stamp visible layer. Basically, it takes everything you see and sticks it on a layer. So we can see I can move this around, and it's its own layer now. Okay, so with the stamp visible, now comes the cool and tricky part. We're going to do something called a step and repeat. And what a step and repeat does is it makes a transformation, and then if you hit a different keyboard shortcut, it's going to repeat that transformation over and over and over and over again until it can't repeat it anymore. So here is our step. To get to the step, you want to hold down Alt and Command or Alt and Control and hit T, as in transform. Okay, so there is our step. Now what we're going to do is I'm just going to make this a little bit smaller. So I'm holding Shift and Alt, and there we go. Let's just make it a bit smaller, and let's go ahead and place it right there because that looks good. Okay, and now we're going to hit Enter. So what we did is we took the entire image and then we put it inside of the projector. Now, because it recorded those transformations, because I held Option Command T, it recorded those. Now all I have to do is hold Shift Option Command and hit T, and it's going to do the same movement over and over and over again, effectively putting the entire image inside of the projector over and over and over again. So let's see if it works. Shift Option Command T, and it's in there. Let's do it again. Command T, Shift Option Command T, it's in there and in there and in there, over and over and over again. How boss is that? Quite boss, Aaron. Thank you for showing me this. You can see it's just over and over and over again. And it puts these on new layers as it goes as well. So you don't have to like manually do anything. It's just gonna do it all for you, which is really nice. Now, if you do wanna use a layer mask, like here, it wasn't perfect. So, you know, it's not a huge deal really. You can use layer masks as well. So like, let's say that we want to just make this, let's put a layer mask on there. There's so many different ways to do things in Photoshop. I'm just gonna get this black to be visible here on the bottom. There we go. And then you could do the same thing here if you wanted to. Let's just get the black line visible there on the bottom. There we go. And that's probably all you'll be able to see as well. So there is our tutorial for the day. So pretty cool effect, right guys? It's like the Russian stacking dolls, right? we can delete this layer. So we've got our extension going on. So this is our original image. We went ahead and extended it up and then just made a new screen, which is not that hard. See, not that hard. And then we went ahead and stacked these inside of one another over and over and over again until you can't see anything anymore, which is very cool. Now, there are a lot of different uses for this technique. I'll just show you one other one real quick and then you guys can just be really happy today. Okay, we'll make a new stamp, a new layer, and you know what? I meant to make that visible. There we go. Let's get that out of the group. Okay. So earlier, there we go. That's what we want. Earlier, we just made it inside of our projector, and you guys can use the same technique with any kind of warp. So this is not going to look as cool, but I'm just showing you guys what you can do. So hold Option Command T and you could like bring this down in size. You could move it over and you can even rotate it. So any of those things that you do, scaling, rotating, and transforming will go over and over again. So if I hold Shift Option Command T again, what it's gonna do is it's now gonna put it on a like slight rotation over and over again. And if you guys have ever seen things like looking down a set of staircases and they seem to like do this forever and ever again. So, you know, Flickr and things like that. This is how they're doing it. They're just doing a step and repeat over and over and over again. And then this is what you wind up getting. It's just a whole bunch of fun copies of something that looks like that. So you guys can use this effect however you want and go get creative with it. have fun. But for now, this is what we're doing. And just a really cool image and a cool effect. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial brought to you exclusively by Phlearn.com. I just wanted to say that. Have a great day, guys. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone. Gracias para watching este tutorial exclusivo por Phlearn.com.